So, do you remember you were telling me a little while ago you had a little bit of a cold?
Yes.
I got a little something to clear you up this morning.
Okay.
Yes.
Marcus, I'm for it.
Mark Casale here from the American Heart Association with our What's for Dinner recipe. And you got something a little hot, a little spicy.
Yeah, we're doing some heart-healthy summertime cooking in Sacramento, and we'll clear up the spicy. We put some hot chilies in there. Really great for the summertime.
Okay, great.
And these are the little culprits we're using today. It's an Asian-style chili, but really, really hot.
What is it called?
It's a bird's-eye chili.
Bird's-eye chili. You just get that at the grocery store?
Actually, I pulled them out of my garden.
Oh.
Of course you did. Yeah, for those absolutely. Of us who don't have them in our garden.
Exactly. You can use a little cayenne. You can use some red pepper flakes. You can use some hot chilies out of the grocery store. Or
great.
For farmers markets, I have everything right now. And that's pretty much what we're doing today. We got great tomatoes, all different shapes and sizes available right now. We got some basil. We got fresh oregano. We have fresh parsley. And we're just going to put it all together into this great little pasta dish that's quick and simple and inexpensive to make.
Okay, so where do we start with
this here?
We
started with some great olive oil. Mm-hmm. About a tablespoon or so. I like to slice my garlic, not chop it, so you get a little bit of texture of the garlic and you can actually bite into it.
Mm-hmm.
We got some sauteed parsley in there right now, and then I just did chopped tomatoes. I seeded them a little bit, so...
Is that just to get a little bit of moisture out?
It is, and I don't really like the seeds. I like the skin because it builds up some pectin, so if you use aromas, just pull the seeds out a little bit.
Okay.
You can use your fingers. Chop them up. That's gone in there. We got that started. This has been cooking for about 15, 20 minutes. It's shrunk down. It's gotten nice and thick. Got some great flavors, great smells going right now. And everything's available in your yard in the farmer's market. Great time to be in Sacramento. We're going to mix that. I'm using a whole wheat penne, actually, right now. The recipe's called fusilli. I didn't have any fusilli, but I did have some whole wheat. Again, the fiber is a little bit better content in the whole wheat. You can use regular pasta if you like. I have the whole wheat to use.
And I think when you have a good sauce on it, it really gives the pasta a little bit more bite.
It does.
I mean, it really, you can eat the healthier stuff.
It's nice and nutty. There's a nutty flavor to it.
And it's really important when you're doing heart healthy to get those big, bold flavors so you don't really miss the salt. There's a tiny pinch of salt in here, but we're really trying to cut back on the salt.
Okay.
I got some leftover roasted chicken. Chicken breast that's shredded. That's going in there. We'll turn up the heat, get this thing really going.
Now, what if I don't have time to stop by the farmer's market, get myself some fresh tomatoes? Can I use some crushed or diced tomatoes for a can in my...
This recipe.
Okay.
No,
you don't recommend.
No.
Take the time to get the fresh stuff.
Exactly.
You can always find a...
That's neighborhood
true.
That has too many tomatoes.
Yeah.
When working with fresh herbs, I try not to cut them up too much. I don't want to crush them because then it tastes like lawn clippings. There's my basil.
And with 10 seconds, we'll tell you, stir it all up. Enjoy. Perhaps a nice glass of wine would be good, I mean.
Ah, yes.
Some oregano.
Mark,
chili's
thank
already
you.
In
don't
there.
Forget, you can always get that recipe at kcra.com/morningnews.